On behalf of my party, YSR Congress Party, and my party president, Sri YS Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu. Thank you very much, sir. Sir, there is great amount of injustice that has been meted out for Andhra Pradesh. Even in this budget and the commitments that have been made in the Reorganization Act. Sir, the first and foremost thing is the special category status which has been assured and by none other than the then Prime Minister of this country in 2014. Sir, I would like to bring to your notice that the special category status for the residuary state of Andhra Pradesh is a lifeline, and there cannot be any substitute for special category status, and special package is no alternative for special category status. Therefore, unless and until special category status is granted to the residuary state of Andhra Pradesh, it can't develop on par with the other equally with the other state, and it has already been left as agrarian state, and in future also it will continue to be agrarian state if special category status is not granted. Sir, the next point is railway zone. There, the railway minister yesterday or day before yesterday, he came to the floor and then has misled the house. I have no hesitation to say that railway minister has misled the house. And he said, see, act does not contemplate the consultation with the other parties. Act has specifically provided that the railway zone would be created, constituted. When act is so specific, why the government is delaying constitution of special category, constitution of railway, separate railway zone? Now railway minister says that he has to consult the other states, he has to consult the other stakeholders. Why is it? So that is one of the provisions that have been incorporated that has to be executed, sir, implemented. Integrated steel plant at Kadapa and port at Dugarajpatnam and Vizag petrochemical complex and Vizag Chennai industrial corridor and metro rail at Vishakhapatnam and Vijayawada. These are all the issues. Apart from this, in Schedule 13, there are a list of 11 central institutions, out of which 9 have been established only in temporary premises, and adequate allocations in the budgets, in the last 4 budgets, have not been made. Therefore, I request the Government of India to address this issue, sir. And, sir, I'll... You have how many minutes you have given me, sir?
Two more minutes.
We are with you.
2 more minutes.
Sir, I'll address only two issues, sir, very important issues. Farmers' distress. Sir, agriculture accounts for 16% of India's GDP and 49% of the India's employment comes from agricultural activities. Sir, National Sample Survey 2013 report shows that 51.9% of the farm households in India are indebted. So this indebtedness by the farmers is to be addressed by the Government of India, as Finance Minister has pointed out. Because minimum support price is concerned, many members have spoken of about that. I'll only say one that. Finance Minister, while presenting the budget of 2017, has categorically stated that the farmer's income, he will ensure that the farmer's income would be doubled in next 5 years by 2022. Therefore, if at all this is to be addressed, and this can be accomplished, and the farmers across the country would be delighted, and they'll remember the ruling party, whichever party does it, they're forever, sir.
Thank you,
sir. One more minute, sir. I'm not touching upon the minimum support price. It is only the cost of production. What is the cost? See, even in the finance minister, when he stated in his budget speech that he is increasing the minimum support price by 150% of the cost, he has not defined what is that cost, whether it is A2 or A2 plus FL or C2. What is that? That has to be spelled out by the Honorable Finance Minister, sir. Sir, one last issue, which is very important issue. Last two issues, sir.
How many last issues?
There are two issues.
No, please.
Farmer producer companies, sir. Sir, to the best of my knowledge, any income from the agriculture is exempted from the tax under Section 2, Subsection 1 of the Income Tax Act.
Yes. Thank you.
Sir, if that is so, It is undoubtedly happy that the finance minister has pointed out that number of farmer producer companies have been set up in India, and they are basically companies set up by the group of farmers. But group of farmers, whether they constitute partnership firm or company or they do it individually, it doesn't make any difference. Agriculture income which is exempted from tax. Sir, the finance minister has exempted this income by these farming companies with a rider, with a sunset clause in the proposal. Why the sunset clause? Sunset clause says that the income of the farmer producer companies are exempted only for a period of 5 years. Why 5 years? When agriculture income is totally exempted from the tax, why 5 years? 5 years tax holiday with a sunset clause.
Yeah.
Therefore, a finance minister.
Yes.
I hope he'll positively
thank
consider
you,
exempting. Sir, one more point, sir. And secondly, sir, even this farming company, farmer companies have to pay distribution tax, dividend distribution, which is totally unreasonable and unwarranted for India's condition, sir.
Yes, yes.
One last, sir. Last.
How many last points? Only one more.
Sir, this is very...
Please conclude.
This is very important, sir. Sir, CAG report, Controller and Auditor General report on government accounting, found that the government has deferred the payments amounting to more than 1.87 lakh crores in 2015-16.
Yeah.
I request the Honorable Finance Minister to address this issue.
Very good.
Therefore, thank you very much.
Thank you, Sarajit.